Finance Committee, April 3rd, 5 o'clock. Roll call, please. Mr. Jones?
Here.
Mr. Gwaltney?
Here.
Mr. Alamon?
Here.
Mrs. Smith?
Here.
And Mr. Harden?
Here.
We're all present.
Wonderful. Okay, we don't have too long of an agenda, but let's plow through it here. Do we have a motion to dispense with the reading of the minutes and approve them as distributed for March 20th?
Did everybody get a copy?
Okay.
I got it, you know.
Okay. Counselor Smith made the motion. Counselor Harden seconded the motion. Any questions, comments? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, by the same sign. That passes 5-0. 250417, request for consideration of 18th Street revitalization project. We have a few dates that Kale was going to update us on.
So this week the contractor is going to continue grading the turn lane on Valley, and then on the 6th he's going to start paving the binder layer up to Valley in the right turn lane, and then milling and paving on Valley and 18th Street the week of the 17th, and temporary striping is going to be placed on 18th Street after that happens, and then Valley turn lane is going to be open after the wearing surface and striping is complete. So today is the 3rd, so hopefully in a couple of weeks they'll get the turn lane open. So 3 weeks maybe.
3 weeks, getting close. All right, any questions on that? Okay, we're going to carry that over till our next meeting for a report. Without objection. Okay, 050323, request to authorize the mayor to sign a contract BJ CTA 2223. I want to thank Mr. Burgett.
Oh, yeah.
It only took him three times.
Four times.
It might have been four times.
Four times, Robert,
to get the contract correct. I believe he sent that out to everybody, so we got them to agree to the payment. As we had understood it, which was level funding and the quarterly payment. So all that, and Mr. Kendrick, you have the contract?
I do.
Okay, yes. Good.
The only thing that we need to make sure that we all are satisfied with is Exhibit A, which is the schedule of the routes.
It was good. It was fine.
The contract's what it is.
All right, I would make a motion to have the mayor sign that contract.
Okay. Moved by Councilor Smith.
I'll second it.
By Councilor Alamon. He was faster, sorry. Any questions? Thank you for your help on that. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, by the same sign. That's 5-0. That passes. 180323, request for permission to authorize the mayor to sign funding agreement for Central Avenue TAP grant. Dale Smith and give us a report on that.
Yeah, so if you'll remember, we received a TAP grant from the RPC in November, and we've been working with, this was the project that we received the TAP grant for. And so it's taken this long to get a funding agreement from LDOT. And so in the TAP grant application, some changes were made this year that allows for the city to include reimbursable for preliminary engineering up to 10% of the total cost estimate. So the total cost estimate was, these are round numbers, was $940,000. So preliminary engineering at the top, the TAP will pay for 75.2, and the city will be on the hook for 18.8. That's all we showed. 94,000 in preliminary engineering was all we showed in the TAP grant application, right? Because that's all we could show. However, that number is actually going to be more, so the city's going to be on the hook for more. So in probably a month or so, I'm going to come back to you guys with an engineering agreement for the same to execute, which is going to be more than that. I just wanted to point all that out because so you would know something else is coming in the future. But this is the funding. This is a part of the very long and lengthy funding agreement. But this is kind of the meat of the company.
This is already budgeted. So this is,
well, so we have funds in the budget for this year to cover what we're going to spend this year,
including the additional costs.
Yes.
And then, you know, I know we've got some numbers that came from a contractor at some point to do that work, but I can't believe the numbers still work based on how long we've been messing with this.
So these numbers were from the application, which was submitted around September.
That was in
August
fall.
Or September.
It should have gone up that much fall.
But my concern is that in 2 years, when this actually goes to construction, they're going to be much higher.
Yeah. Is that the timing of it? Is 2 years out?
We're probably looking at a year before we go to construction.
And Kale, because of the construction that's going on for the restaurant and for the bank that are going kind of in front of where this is going to be, is that going to, I mean, that should, we should probably wait till that's all done anyway, right?
So they, I mean, even if this started tomorrow, I don't think we would be on top of each other, but
okay.
In each other's way. But I mean, even if, I think their schedule is to finish up by December,
okay.
And we'll be behind them.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Let me ask this question. On the left side, Griffin Creek, and right below that on 28, see that little building there?
I do.
So.
It's not there anymore.
It's not there
no,
anymore.
No, I know. And so I think, who owns that? Does the guy that bought?
Jared.
Jared bought that, and I assume he bought that for parking, I guess, because he's now got a gravel, they've kind of graveled it a little bit.
Right.
Is that getting our way? Is that, I mean?
That's not going to get in our way. We have significant right of way there
okay.
to do our
yeah.
project.
And we met with them and talked to them about what's going on, so they're aware.
Okay.
And all, I mean, since you pointed this out, so this is only conceptual. This isn't what is going to be built. We don't know for sure what's going to happen because we haven't gotten a survey and started designing. This is just the intent of the application.
Okay. Any questions?
Let's make a motion for approval.
Second. Okay. Move by Councilor Gwaltney. And I think I heard Councilor Smith second that. And you have the proper account numbers, right?
Yes,
okay.
I did. Thank you.
Attach that. Okay. So, any other questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed by the same sign. 5-0. That passes. 190323. Request for permission to authorize the mayor to sign an agreement and resolution for the transfer of ownership and maintenance of road segments along Forest Brook. I think everyone will be pleased to hear this report.
So, this is a plat from before the interstate was built, or when they were building it, and this is the interstate through here, and then Forest Brook is here. There was a drainage issue a couple of years ago around this area. There's a drainage well that comes through here, and a pipe goes across the road. And the city was about to fix it, and then we had survey go out and determine that all this was actually Aldott right of way, all the way up to the edge of this hatching. And so Aldott said, okay, that's right, it's our property. They fixed the pipe, and now they're asking the city to take ownership of what we already maintained, because we already maintained some of Forest Brook anyway. So this just kind of cleans up. So what they're asking the city to take is what's in the hatched area. And it includes two uneconomic remnants.
And so we were already, really, we've already been maintaining Forest Brook.
Yeah,
anyway.
That's a good picture. So
we do all the
mowing and everything.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So this would clean up. So right now their right of way comes through here.
Yeah.
And it would take their interstate right of way to the fence.
And the remnants are two pieces of property that they're going to gift us, I guess, as a part of all this.
You
can't
property.
Okay. You can't build on them.
Spot spaces.
But the important part here is that we got the surveyor to look at it and determine that before we
spent money on it. Yeah.
To fix the pipe. So
there, we fixed it.
I like it.
Yes. And fixed, and then we'll take it.
All right. Well, I would make a motion for us to sign the agreement and take ownership of that.
Second question.
Okay. Hold on a second. Councilor Smith made a motion. Councilor Oliver seconded, and the question.
Mr. Squires,
yes.
You've looked at this, and you're okay with the repair they made? Okay. Just want to make sure.
We were already doing, like Kale said, that the one is that pipe, and I mean, it was
none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed by the same sign, 5-0, that passes. 2003-23, request to accept community grant for outdoor shading in Homewood and amend the 22-23 grants fund budget. So we're happy about this.
Very happy about this.
Where are we shading on that?
We are shading the tennis courts,
Seating area.
Thank you. We, as you know, our tennis program has exploded, and there's just no shade out there. There's no, there's really not a lot of seating either, so this is actually going to be included in this seating as well. So there are some benches, but there are people out there all the time.
Is there a contract?
What's that?
Is there a contract?
Robert's got the, no, it was a discretionary fund from Commissioner Ammons.
It'll be recorded as grant revenue. And then the expense will be an 020 park capital expenditure.
That's great.
Do you need anything from that?
We've already received the funds, and we put them to Jefferson County Revenue Other, because at the time I received them, I didn't know what they were needed to be applied to. And then after we had a chance to run it down, we realized Ms. Andrews told us that it was from, it was Ammons, is that correct?
Yes, Steve Ammons.
And that it was for
Shading.
Park shading.
That's great. Very, super exciting.
So you don't need to, we have the funds. This is just, just to accept it and amend the fund budget with that amount so we can.
Right. It'll be recorded as revenue and 0203-432-000 rent revenue, and it'll be a 0220-576-915 park grant capital expenditure.
All right, and I would make a motion to approve accepting that.
Second.
All right.
We're accepting a lot of grants.
Councilor Smith, I know, I love it. And seconded by Councilor Hardin. I love those. We got another one coming.
Yeah.
Any other questions? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed by the same sign. That passes 5-0. 2103-23, request to accept grant and amend the 22-23 grants fund budget for police grant. You have a report on this.
Yes, sir. This is another issue where we had received $2,000 from Jefferson County, and it was put to Jefferson County Revenue Other. And in researching it, it was for our police department, for them to use as they saw fit within the city of Homewood Police Department. And we that will be recorded as grants revenue in 0302, and then the expenditure will be 0214 police grants capital expenditure. And it was $2,000 was the amount.
Same thing, you don't need anything?
Correct. No, sir. I don't believe so.
So I said it was from Jefferson County. Was it from
Jefferson County?
Yeah.
It was just Jefferson County Commission. It wasn't specific. I'm not sure.
Okay. All right. I'll make a motion to approve accepting that grant as well.
Okay. Councilor Smith made the motion. Councilor Alamon seconded. Any other questions? All in favor say aye.
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 All opposed by the same sign. That passes 5-0. 2203-23, request to amend Green Springs Highway and design agreement with Kimley Horn, Berkeley.
That's what this is the is that connector between is it Woodmont and Green Springs. You know, they've had to go in and go work with ALDOT to get permission and all that stuff. So I will say this: we've got $850,000 in the budget for that last phase. You want to take it out of that, and then we'll see where the bids come in on that. I mean, I just seem to do that as doing a transfer right now. We can wait and look at it later if you want to. That's no big deal either way. So.
And the last phase is taking us from?
Basically from Broadway. We'll pave all the way to the bridge, but it'll do that, you know, the pedestrian thing on the side there of the creek, and then it'll also connect to Woodmont. But this was their work because they ended up having to get in with ALDOT and do a bunch of stuff on Lakeshore to be able to get the connector there.
So your recommendation is to take it out of the
remaining? I would just, if you guys are good, just let me take it out of that, and then if the bids come in higher than the whatever,
and
I
you can request
that one.
And when are we going to bid on that last phase?
Probably
end of the year?
Mid, late summer.
Oh, okay, so.
And
maybe sooner.
money coming from the Green Springs revitalization? Is that the same line item?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, that's it.
You need a resolution?
I don't think so, because it's paying for the Green Springs, that part of it, so I don't think we need a resolution on it. I was just gonna take it out of that instead of having a transfer.
Okay, so I guess a proper motion is to authorize expenditure for the amended Green Springs Highway agreement with Kimley Horn, coming out of phase three.
Yeah.
Line item.
Do we know the cost is?
Yeah.
Just $35,000.
$35,000.
All right, I would make the motion to approve that.
Second.
Okay, Counselor Smith made the motion, Counselor Hardin seconded the motion. Any other questions on that? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, by the same sign. All right, 5-0, that passes. And the last item, another grant, I'm loving it. Got lots of these. Request to accept the 2023 Blue Cross Blue Shield Alabama campaign grant of $50,000.
Yes, thank you to Mr. Squires and especially to Jacob Stevens, who wrote the application for this grant to Blue Cross Blue Shield. This is in association with the outdoor fitness court through the fitness campaign. We were awarded the top amount for the grant from Blue Cross Blue Shield. They were awarding $30,000, $40,000, and $50,000 grants. We got a $50,000 grant, which is fantastic. And so all we are doing at this point is accepting the grant, and we need a resolution
this month.
Yeah, we told them we would do that at our council meeting in April. And we've also told them already that this would not be until, we did not budget anything in this budget year for this. So we told them that that would be in the 23-24 budget. But in the meantime, we are working to possibly secure some more sponsorship money that would either defray this cost further or possibly take away this cost to the city altogether, you know, if we're successful in that. So we've got time before all this comes together, but right now
but
we just
you
need
want
to
go
accept
ahead
the
and
grant.
Accept the
yes,
grant.
Yes, they'd like to do that because that just helps them in whatever process they have.
Okay, and you can get that to Mike.
Yes, and it actually actually asked for Barkley's signature.
Okay.
I just noticed. Yeah, so we're all good.
Okay, so
do you want to sign?
Well, I guess Barkley, because y'all names on it. Your name, it says Barkley Squires.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they put you as the signer. So
is that
I'd make
your
a
motion?
Yes, I would make a motion to approve accepting the grant.
Second.
Okay, moved by Counselor Smith, seconded by Counselor Gwaltney. Thank you for your work on that,
well,
both of you.
Exciting, yeah.
Okay. Any other questions? Hearing none. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? All right, 5-0. That passes. And I believe that is it. So, and you provide a report next time. Is that okay? So you were going to give a general report on a few things.
On the green light?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, with that, we're adjourned.